Let's express our gratitude to Your Excellency for accepting to receive us in audience the second time in 5 months at a very short notice. We feel honored and privileged by this gesture. The people of this island bring you warm felicitations and appreciation for your thoughtful intervention in various areas that directly impact on them and the state at large. Congratulations, sir. I will pray that you will sustain the efforts to develop our state. Excellency, I wish to reiterate that your desire to engage Edo youths productively received a boost last week when 10 design youths sponsored by our association were decorated with PTI Skills Acquisition Proficiency Certificate in Welding and Fabrication after a 9-month long training. They distinguished themselves in both written examination and the proficiencies for practical tests conducted by the Petroleum Training Institute, PTI Warri, as certified by the Nigerian Institute of Welding and the International Institute of Welding. You confidently challenged us to cross-check our facts and obtain current status of government intervention on these issues, thereby opening your doors for us to re-engage you should new findings emerge from our investigations. Various committees were set up to address the above issues. Your Excellency, we are delighted to announce that visible successes have been recorded since our meeting. Most heartwarming is the reinstatement of the energy of Kurobi to the throne of his ancestors. The people of this land, thank you immensely. And before this gesture, I wish to assure you of our continuous and sustained support to your government. 2 weeks after the visit, an AEP fact-finding team led by one of our members, Professor Michael Gayale, went to the College of Education Guelben against the backdrop of the SOS message from the Guelben community, our opposition that you had approved funding for the institution. Your Excellency, you were right. Not only has the institution received state government funding, there is renewed enthusiasm at the institution. Today has not been an exception. I mean, for the fact that you are receiving us for the second time in 5 months shows your open door policy. And also the opportunity this meeting has provided for us to address some of the money issues relating to the Southland and indeed the Edo State.
President, we appreciate you on behalf of the government for their selflessness and interest in your people, in our people, that you have been able to raise money in your own resources to train 10 youths in welding and fabrication is an action that is most commendable. And I will assure you that we will support you.
Yes.
Give priority job placements to them, particularly in the projects we are working. Our emphasis, you know, for the last time, so we deal with the problem at least at the core, at the foundation, and throw the bulk of the resources into it. Once the foundation is well laid, once the foundation is strong, we can build it from the Just to also inform you that we are working very, very hard to first obtain their data, put out their new jobs, and see how we can help them training and match the training jobs, just like we have just done with these 10 or 20 young men and women. It's a strategy that the state government has adopted, and we will be calling on you for more support. Show you what we've done with the new jobs database, the sort of profiling in terms of skills, matching in terms of the corporate bodies that can get training from, and then to that, vocational opportunities and vocational. transfer or opportunities in entrepreneurship. So the focus for us is to build from the base. I want to assure you that so far, so good. The response we've gotten from our pilot of our first 300 primary schools has been tremendous. The response from the teachers has been beyond our expectation. So we trained about 2,000 of our primary school teachers, and we trained another 5,000 during this holiday period, all in preparation for what we call Edubest, because for that, and if I've said, if there's one legacy I want to leave us all, it's that turnaround education is fully different in these days. So that leads me into the bigger issue. One of the reasons why we haven't set up the voice or council support about tertiary institutions is because we are re-examining the whole run-on on which higher education rests. If it's broken, if there's a problem, let's not just paper over it and continue business as usual. Fortunately, our Commissioner for Education is close to you. His son was also in the system. And what we've decided to do is to rethink, we're rethinking education in every state. And he just come out with two papers, a strategic plan on education and a policy, a state policy on education. These are documents we're going to make available. We want input so we can look at them critically with a clear implementation plan. Where should we be putting our money? Which is your right? Should it be basic and professional technical? How do we pay for those areas we're not emphasizing? Should I continue? $3 billion every year in Ebola? Or should I just put more money in my secondary schools? These are all issues we must all talk about and debate. Let's not pretend that, oh yeah, black is good. I mean, we can't, there are resource constraints, so we need to prioritize. But let's not think about our future, think about the country and the state we want to build, and now decide what to do. Let's not be afraid. It's very fundamental decisions that need to be made. And that's why I'm quite glad that I have people who are very strong intellectually, who have a lot of experience, to sit with us. And let's boldly and fearlessly make those decisions for the sake of action and the sake of community. And so I'm hoping that all of this gets completed within this month of August so that we can get the point and decide and get all these institutions going. I mean, why must I have three colleges of education? Why can't I have one with three campuses? Why, what must each one of them do? Should they have education? You know, it's like we just, over the last 3 to 4 decades, we just kept ruling government like the amount of course. Now we have all these institutions, but they're not worth much, unfortunately. And I don't think that I would like to pretend, and act like I should, a politician, and say because I didn't vote and all that, then it doesn't know what they could do with that. On the issue of different language, I think it's policy to adopt it, that dual languages should be taught in schools. But I haven't looked at that. I'm doing so much because I'm going on everybody. But you also need to help me to justify the test you have extended. Because not to, you know, not be fair. I know how much I put in. And I have a standing contractor, so I will stand by with regular monthly payments to just be fixing their own business. And I will continue to. But I think it's only fair that I agree with it. So on that note, in one local government, I tell my local government, Citizen Central and $4 billion to do the economy. Every